In this video, I'm going to be interviewing my wholesale mentor, Dylan Frost. Now, we're going to be focusing on wholesale in this interview, and more specifically, the mistakes that most Amazon sellers make when they buy and sell wholesale stuff on Amazon. So if you are trying to make wholesale work with Amazon and you're finding out that it's not working very well, you might be making these mistakes. And if you're interested in learning about, you know, selling wholesale on Amazon, these are the mistakes that you can avoid. So learn them now so you can avoid them. So this interview is also, the audio of it is from our Full-Time FBA Show podcast. So if you're not subscribed to that, be sure to go to fulltimefba.com/podcast so that you can get all of our podcast episodes. Every once in a while, we'll record a video interview, and that's what we're doing in this video right here. So let's get right to that interview. My interview with Dylan Frost, focusing on wholesale mistakes most Amazon sellers make.
All right, I'm here with Dylan Frost from The Wholesale Formula, one of my mentors who has helped me big time to succeed with wholesale. And today we're going to be talking about wholesale mistakes that a lot of people make. And these wholesale mistakes cause people to, quit trying to buy and sell wholesale stuff on Amazon. Dylan, thanks so much for joining me today. How's it going?
Hey, it's going great. I love being here. Love getting to hang out and talk with you. One of my favorite people in the world. So really excited. Aww.
That's awesome. My heart is warmed. I appreciate you saying that. So wholesale, obviously, it's a big deal. It gives a big promise of what it can deliver when it comes to sales and profits and scalability and long-term success. But you got to know the right way to do it. And that's what I love about the wholesale formula is there's a formula to make sure you get it done right. So let's dig into, I want to read through some different excuses people have given me, reasons why they've quit selling on Amazon when it comes to wholesale, and you can kind of break down what went wrong and maybe how to better do things the right way. So the first one, I hear people say, you know, I go to Google and I just Google wholesale brands, and I start looking at brands and trying to reach out to brands, and I'm not really finding stuff that's profitable, and I'm not really finding very many good brands. And so, you know, I decided to quit. So where did things go wrong there?
Yeah, that's a common one. So let me demystify this process a bit and start with explaining that. So my business partner and I, Dan, have sold over $30 million worth of products wholesale, okay, on Amazon, right? It means we bought the product wholesale and resold it on Amazon at a profit, over $30 million. So we've got a lot of experience doing this. And when we first started, it was really challenging to figure out. Like, we saw some other people were having some success with wholesale, or a lot of other people were actually like us and didn't know how to figure it out. We kind of stumbled upon this nearly by accident. Part of it was a trusted friend of ours who kind of like led us in the right direction and said something that was really smart one time. And then we were like, okay, we'll look into that. So this whole process of, like, if you go to Google and you're just like wholesale sources and you type them up, what you're going to get on there is a list of wholesalers or distributors. That's what you're always going to get when you do that, when you go looking on the internet for wholesale sources. What a wholesaler or a distributor is a big company that carries lots of different brands, hundreds or in some cases thousands or even tens of thousands of different brands' products. They're basically a sales agent. They are a middleman who works with independent brands, and they just have these big catalogs of products. Now, so this will be a long answer, but it's important that we go right through this one so that everyone fully understands of like what it is that we do and the effective ways to actually do wholesale, especially with Amazon. So wholesalers and distributors are basically, they're still useful, but they're mostly an artifact of the past. So let's think it's the year 1970. Remember, it's the year 1970, and you're opening up a general store in your town, in your small town in Texas or wherever that you live. To be able to fill your store full of goods, you had two options. You could either independently set up direct buying accounts with 350 different brands to fill your store, and have 350 different invoices that have to be paid and shipped out, and 350 different deliveries that have to take place for all your store to be filled full of product, right, your general store. Or you work with just one distributor or one or two wholesalers where they have all the their catalog of inventory and all their connections. They've already done that for you so that you can just make one order to buy all these different products to fill your store with. That's what wholesalers and distributors were primarily used for and how that they were valuable and effective. Here's the problem with wholesalers and distributors when it comes with Amazon is that they are middlemen, so they have a markup on the product, which makes it more expensive, which makes it more difficult for you to profit when you use wholesalers and distributors. So really, that's a number one reason right there in most cases. I mean, you can be profitable. You can work. It is possible to use wholesalers. It's possible to use distributors. I'm not saying that it isn't, that you can't have right. profit, but it is superior to not use those middlemen, to not use those wholesalers and distributors when you can avoid it, because they do have to make money too, right? It's business. So they have their own markups on those products. So we kind of realized this early on. And so instead of going to these wholesalers, or even though wholesale's in the name, it's not that you're working with wholesalers, it's that you're buying in wholesale quantities. Mm-hmm. So we're still wanting to do wholesale. So what we decided was, okay, instead of going to these wholesalers and distributors, and that process is really tedious, where you go to a wholesaler or distributor, you ask to see what their catalog is, what products that they carry, and then you have to go through this huge list and see, like, does any of this make sense to sell on Amazon? Would any of this be effective? It's very time consuming and arduous and lame. Instead, what we started doing and where we started having success was we would look for products to sell on Amazon. We would scout and look on Amazon. We developed our own criteria, which we call the wholesale formula now, our own criteria to look through Amazon itself and identify great wholesale opportunities, great product opportunities. We would find the exact product that we would want to sell that we know that we could make significant profit from. And then instead of trying to find a wholesaler or distributor that sells that product, we would contact, and we still do this, we contact the brand directly. We would contact, call them up or send them an email, the brand themselves, to open up a direct buying account with them, a direct account where there's no middlemen involved. It's us buying directly from that brand and us being as an approved, authorized seller, retailer of their products on Amazon. Here's the great thing about that. When you're able to do that and you open up that direct relationship, that direct buying account, you're able to get the best possible price. When you have the best possible price, for any of you that have experience with Amazon, you get a lot more of the sales, or in some cases all of the sales, because mm-hmm. if people can't compete with you based on your price, because if you're getting a better price, well, then you can get all the profits too. So it's very valuable, and I'm sure we'll talk a little bit more about some of the other things, with some of the other mistakes people make, about how that's very possible for you to do, because I'll also speak to another objection or thing that we used to have around that. We used to thought, and we believed this in part because other people told it to us, mm-hmm. and without actually checking to see ourselves, we thought that you couldn't buy direct from brands because it would be too expensive. Or when I say too expensive, that their minimum orders would be too high. People would tell us, like, yeah, if you're wanting to do brand direct wholesale like that, their order minimums are $15,000, $20,000, $50,000, $100,000. And we just kind of believed the people that had told us that. And they weren't lying. They were just telling us for companies that weren't in the wheelhouse of what we would be doing anyway. They were telling us, like, yeah, if you want to work with Hasbro directly, the minimum order is $500,000. But it's like, that's not the kind of wholesale accounts we're creating, which I know that we're going to talk about here in a little bit. So yeah, many brands that would be very profitable for you on Amazon, their minimum orders are actually as low as, $250, $500, $1,000. Like it can be that low for you to get started brand direct if you are just targeting the right companies.
Yeah, that was one of my biggest mistakes with my very first wholesale order. I didn't realize I was buying from a distributor who was, buying it brand direct and raising the price. And, I bought my inventory and ended up, it was just, I bought my inventory at the wrong time because it was just when other people were sold out on Amazon. And so by the time my inventory got live after buying directly from a distributor instead of the brand directly, all those other people who bought it at the lower prices were back in stock. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm just trying to break even with the inventory that I had just sent in.
We made that same mistake at a trade show once, and it was a big mistake. You know, it was like a $20,000 mistake at a trade show before we figured out this whole process for doing wholesale the right way. So it's, you know, luckily we got to make those mistakes, so the people that we've been able to work with, we can help them avoid them.
Right. And that's why I wanted to talk about mistakes in this podcast episode, because, you know, these mistakes cost us a lot of money, cost you a lot of money. And so we want to help save other people from making those same mistakes. The second mistake that I hear people say a lot, or the excuse that they use why wholesale is not working, is that, well, I reached out to Hasbro or Nike or, you know, Hamilton Bay or all these other type of big name brands, and none of them would even talk to me. I don't even have a brick and mortar store, and they want me to have a brick and mortar store. These brands won't talk to me. How can I make money selling wholesale when these big brands won't even talk to me?
Yeah. That's a really important part of this. So, well, I like to use the phrase the Goldilocks zone. Okay, so if anyone knows science a little bit, the Goldilocks zone kind of represents the perfect temperature and the perfect life sustaining different components that enable us to, you know, be on Earth and everything and life be able to be sustained here. And it's the same kind of thing with wholesale brands and products. There is a Goldilocks zone, or there is a type of brand and a size of brand that is just right. Okay, so there are brands any brand that you've almost ever heard of, like, that's kind of the way that I can start for people to understand, is like, if you've ever heard of the brand before, Or you know, or like it's something that you've heard of or that you know about, they're probably too big for it to make sense for you to do brand direct wholesale with. You know, if a brand is any brands that are doing over $100 million in sales a year, they're just too big. We have found that brands like you would it's hard for you to imagine, right? It's like, it's hard to quantify until you start like really digging into it. But like, you know, I've sold $30 million worth of wholesale products wholesale on Amazon. It's very likely that whoever's listening right now, you've never heard of any of those brands or products before. Mm-hmm. Never. And imagine that ad infinitum. There's so many brands that sell millions of dollars every year on Amazon that you have never heard of and probably never will hear of, but mm-hmm. there's a lot of profit that can be made with them. And those companies, they may have one employee, just the owner, or 2, 3, 4, 5 to 15 mm-hmm. employees. So companies that are under 20 employees, companies that are between, like, the total company revenue is somewhere between like $1 million and $15 million. That's really like our Goldilocks zone of brands that we target. And you get good at figuring out what brands are these things that we can target, and we have a really good chance of making a great relationship with them, of working with them, of buying direct, and working out really well for us and for them. So what it comes down to is you're identifying products that are successful on Amazon that you've never really heard of before. They're not major brands. They're not these big part of multi-conglomerate billion-dollar corporations. Those are the gold mines. Those are the mm-hmm. best places for you to be able to land great accounts that can pay you out. And also, what's also great is, you know, we've been doing this a long time now. Many of these brands, we worked with them when they were having initial success 5, 6 years ago, and we've grown with them. You know, mm-hmm. we've been with brands where they were doing 100K on Amazon a year, and now they're doing, you know, 1.5 million, 2 million. We've been with them the whole way, and so that's another great thing about it too, is you get to experience that growth and grow with them too in some cases.
Yeah, it's like our mind thinks, well, if I've never heard of this brand, it's not going to make me any money. I need to find a popular brand that everyone knows and everyone loves and everyone goes and looks at, wants to buy. But yeah, those are just way too far out of our league at this point. And so, yeah, you can find, you know, like you said, like little mom and pop run businesses that they sell something really cool and have a brand. Maybe they've got, you know, only 5 inventory items or products that are available. Maybe they've got 500. You know, there's a different range, but you can find the smaller brands are still potentially brands that you can make thousands of dollars every single month on Amazon over and over again. And so, yeah, that just opens up the doors when you finally change that mindset of, I don't need a Nike or a Hasbro or something like that to really be successful. I can just have a whole lot of these smaller brands that add up over time and can sell very quickly and awesome on Amazon.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yep. All right. So the next thing that I hear is one that almost every Amazon seller hears at one point, and that's that people say, I can't sell wholesale on Amazon because by the time I talk to the purchase or the seller, the actual brand directly, they find out I'm an Amazon seller. They're like, nope, we're not accepting any more Amazon sellers, or we don't sell to Amazon sellers. And they say, no, the door is closed and I can't do anything else after that. So I quit. There's been too many people tell me, no, they won't allow Amazon sellers to sell their brand. So why are they completely wrong in worrying about this reply?
Yeah, this is like a mindset shift that people need to have. And it's like the difference between being someone that wants to just try to make money and being a person that wants to own a real business. And it's like, once you understand the mindset or what business actually is when everything will be opened up to you and you'll start to be becoming wildly more successful than you ever would or before or ever could have been without this realizing this. And it's simple, right? Brands are telling you that if you're reaching out to brands or you're seeing that, they're telling you that for a reason. So let's think about the way I like to explain all that is like this, right? In the United States, the form of commerce that we have is capitalism. What is capitalism? And what drives capitalism? And that is competition. And with competition, let's just extrapolate even further. What perpetuates competition? And that's an exchange of value. So there has to be a pretty fair exchange of value in all parts, like in all parts of the chain. So we have a brand, for instance, right? We have a brand who has a successful product and it's selling on Amazon. And it's selling on Amazon regardless of if you're selling it or not. You know, let's think about it this way. A brand has a successful product. Let's say you're selling it, Stephen, for them, and it's selling 200 units a month. If I started buying from the brand and selling on Amazon, it's not going to, and I did nothing, and I provided no value to that brand other than to just list it and sell it for Amazon, it's still going to sell 200 times a month. So adding you as a seller in that instance provides the brand no value. Therefore, they are not incentivized to work with you. It's as simple as that. So how you flip that script and fix and solve that problem is you have to be able to convince them, that's the important part, convince them and prove to them that you can be valuable to them as a retailer on Amazon, and that you can take their sales from 200 a month to maybe 250 or 300 or whatever it may be. And then if you can do that and provide that value and convince them, then they'll want to work with you. And then it's symbiotic, because if you're not providing value to them, you're just someone who wants to put in an order and it does, like, then of course they don't want to work with you. So it's about always remembering, you have to be able to provide value to get value back. You can't be a leech and just only extract value. That's not how capitalism works. That's not how competition works. That's not how building a real business works. I can't be just this person who isn't providing any value to anyone and hope that everyone's just going to grant me all these golden tickets where I can sell these products and make money and be profitable. It doesn't work that way. So once you understand that, what can I give, what can I do to be of service, be of value, there's a lot of things, a whole lot of things, then that's where it all starts to just really, the dam breaks open for you, and you can just be wildly successful, not just with wholesale, but with a lot of things, when you realize the trade of value.
Yeah, so let's break that down, because the last thing that I want to talk about when it comes to the mistakes people make, they're not providing that value. So, they're making the big mistake by not providing the value. So, what are some of the value things that people like, you and me, everyday sellers on Amazon, can provide to a brand to convince them to allow you to sell their stuff on Amazon?
Nearly unlimited. Let's think about some of the really simple ones, easy ones to follow and understand. We could sit here and talk for hours or days about all the different ones that we've ever provided for a brand. So you don't need to be super knowledgeable. You don't need to be super smart. You just have to have common sense. If you have common sense, you can provide a tremendous value to a brand. So really, and Steven, you may be able to like just throw up examples of this to people so that they can see. But if anyone ever like spends some time shopping on Amazon and cruising through product listings on Amazon, many of them are absolutely terrible, just mind-bogglingly bad, in all aspects. Like something that's an example that I like to use a lot, help people to really understand that one that's criminal and you see all the time is a food product. There'll be a food product which will not include any photos of what the food looks like. It just includes the only photo on the listing is a photo of the packaging. And the way that I like to explain that to people is like, imagine that, you went to a restaurant and you're looking at the menu, and you know how sometimes the menu has pictures of the food so that, to help you decide if you want that or not. Imagine if the pictures on the menu were pictures of the packaging that the food came in, and you're trying to make your decision to eat. Like that's what those Amazon listings are effectively are. It's like, no. If they were actually showing what the food looked like and what it looked like prepared in a delicious meal and so on and so forth, it would significantly increase its sales, its conversion. More people would be buying that product because they'd be more comfortable. It's like, so like that's an simple example, incredibly simple example. So if you find a brand like that who they're selling decently, but they don't have any photos of their food prepared or out of the packaging, that's something that you should talk to them about that would significantly increase conversion. And how do you fix that? It's super simple. You just ask, like, the brand already has photos of their food prepared, I guarantee it. So you just ask them, or you pull them off their website, or you ask them to send them to you, and you can upload them to Amazon in a matter of minutes. It's as simple as that. And that's another thing, that's a misconception. People think you can't change listings for brands or for other products. You absolutely can. This is like a huge myth that exists for some reason. You can ch I can change the listing for nearly any listing on Amazon, if I wanted to, with all the methods that we know
Yeah,
how.
there's multiple ways to do that. And so if you just know one, yeah, it might not work one way, but there are multiple ways to get that done for sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. So yeah, being able to provide value by improving those product listings. I know I was able to really impress a brand before because they had some negative feedback on their product that was actually feedback for the seller who sold their product, not actually about the particular product. And so, I was able to go in and get some of those negative feedback scores removed, which increased the, search results for that product that helped them get better ranking when it comes to the search results for certain keywords because they had better reviews because some of the negatives were gone. So little things like that can add up. And yeah, there are unlimited numbers of ways that you can really provide a service to a brand to help increase the sales on Amazon, which will allow you to become a seller and then also help you sell more than if you just left it alone for sure. So we've talked about some ways that people have made wholesale mistakes in the past, how to kind of overcome that. Coming up next week, if you're listening to this when the podcast drops, coming up next week we have a free wholesale workshop, a webinar that's focused completely on how to add wholesale and sourcing strategies to your Amazon business. Can you talk a little bit about what that webinar is going to be on, what people are going to learn, and I'll be sure to provide a link also where people can sign up.
Yeah, definitely. So we're going to go in depth on like end to end how that you can start searching Amazon yourself and identifying these great product opportunities that we've already talked about. Not only identify what a great product opportunities, but how we use our wholesale formula system to identify not only what's a great opportunity, but how good of an opportunity. Like all the way down to you'll be able to pretty accurately estimate how many of this product that you could sell and even how much money that you could be making off of it if you were able to sell it. So really the promise is by the end of that training, you'll be able to go on Amazon and find not only find how to start finding wholesale products just like that we've been able to sell over the years and brands where you can land them direct accounts so that they're replenishable products. You order again and again every month. Once you get set up, it's as simple as, you just order every month or every couple months. More product comes in, you send it into Amazon, and so it's just this constant revenue stream for you. That's very easy and simple for you to take advantage of after the initial setup. But not only are we going to show you how to find them, we're going to give you strategies and things that you can put into practice to start landing those accounts and doing some of the things that we said and providing some of those simple values that anyone can do that brands desperately need. There are literally millions of products listed on Amazon and hundreds of thousands of different brands. So there's more than enough to go around for a lot of people. And you just need one, two, or three to be making a real income. You know, we've got accounts that literally bring in just a single brand direct relationship that brings in between 300 and half a million a year in profit, just one. So it's like in some cases you can hit it like that. You can hit these gigantic, incredibly profitable accounts. They're out there, or just a few small ones that add up. There's a lot to it. So definitely make sure you don't miss it.
Yeah. And I want to just say that if you're thinking about coming to this free wholesale workshop, I want you to do whatever you can to sign up for it right now, because this is information that they should be charging you money for. I mean, this is stuff that's going to be so good. You can easily pay really good money for this content, but they're going to be giving it away for free. So if you're on a jog, on a walk, if you're driving, pull over to the side of the road, stop whatever you're doing right now, go to the link fulltimefba.com/wholesale workshop, and you will be able to sign up for this webinar that's coming up. I mean, if you happen to be listening to this, you know, months after it drops, if you go to that same link, fulltimefba.com/wholesale workshop, you'll be signed up for a wait list to be notified if we do this again in the future, because this webinar is going to be a limited time access. It's only going to be up for a short time. It's not going to stay up forever. So you want to do whatever you can do. This is must see TV. This is, you know, got to be there. If you sign up for the webinar, you'll get access to a limited time replay. You know, you want to do everything you can to be there live and to take action. So again, fulltimefba.com/wholesale workshop. Again, Dylan, y'all should be selling this, but you're giving it away for free. So I appreciate the generosity of you and Dan, because that's one of the things I love about both you and Dan. Back in 2015, I was dabbling with wholesale, trying to get things to work and trying to learn how to do it. I took a wholesale course. It didn't work for me. I took another wholesale course. It didn't work for me. I read a book that I paid really good money for about wholesale on Amazon. That didn't work for me, and I was ready to give up. And then I got on the phone with Dan, talked with him. He got me started and walked me through a lot of what we're going to be going through on this very first webinar that's coming up, fulltimefba.com/wholesale workshop. And all of a sudden, the light bulb went off above my head, and I said, oh my gosh, this is like revolutionary. And now, every year since then, you know, from 2015 on, every year I've been able to increase my wholesale profits and continually reorder stuff via wholesale on a month-by-month basis, where I'm able to send in inventory, it sells, and before it sells out, I reorder more, send it back into Amazon, and it's just like a lot of stuff is just on autopilot now, because I just, you know, put in the hard work to find the wholesale account, but then just kind of reorder every month or so. And it just has been a huge game changer for me in my life. And so I'm thankful that you and Dan have come together to put together this wholesale workshop for us. And we're going to walk us through what we're doing, because the possibilities really are endless. So thank you for putting this together.
Yeah. And we do, you know, we do charge for this. We actually charge for this throughout the year. And lots of people sign up for this training and pay for it. But, you know, we've known Steven a long time. And so friends of his, people in his audience, that we're going to do this special. It will be limited time, though. That's the thing. It's like, we can't, because we do charge for this, we can't leave the replays and stuff open all the time and that sort of thing. So that's why it has to be just a limited time thing.
Yeah. And so, again, like I said, make this a priority, because if you're like, man, maybe I'll do this next year, you're going to waste a year of your time without this information. This information really will revolutionize your Amazon business, will help you open a lot of doors, help start to snowball your profits, and give you the more freedom that you know, selling on Amazon with wholesale items can provide for you. So, Dylan, thanks again for hanging out with me, doing this interview with me. I really appreciate your time. And, you know, we'll be sure to put everything, all these links on our show notes page. But is there any final words you want to leave everyone with when it comes to selling on Amazon or being curious about selling on Amazon when it comes to wholesale?
Really, what stands in the way of you accomplishing it, whatever it is that you want when it comes to financial freedom or even if it's simpler goals than that with Amazon, what we have found to be obviously for us the best way has been through wholesale and this specific method of wholesale, working with brands directly. We've worked with people for about 5 years now, and the people that we've worked with have combined to sell over $1 billion on Amazon. That's $1 billion. But here's the thing about that. The people that we've worked with have combined to sell $1 billion, but Amazon is doing hundreds of billions of dollars in sales every year.
Yeah,
and they're growing rapidly. I haven't looked at their stock price recently, but I imagine it's probably up still and continuing to climb, and their revenues continue to climb. Last year was the biggest year of growth that Amazon has seen in quite some time, in a COVID year, and they're continuing to massively grow and take up more market share, which just means there's more and more opportunity for people like us. We just continue to see our profits grow every single year because we are along for this ride of growth with Amazon, and there's really no better way to take advantage of it than wholesale, because it gives you the ability to be super flexible and fluid and take advantage of the marketplace no matter where it is at the time. So it's another reason why it's great.
Yeah. So if you're frustrated with retail arbitrage and trying to find your next big, you know, inventory haul, or if you're frustrated with online arbitrage, not knowing if you're getting a good deal on things and wondering where you're going to find, you know, the next inventory order for you, if you're able to get wholesale relationships, again, you can have consistent monthly sales that you reorder on a monthly basis all year long. And it's awesome and amazing. So thanks again, Dylan, for hanging out with me. And we'll see you. We'll see everybody at the wholesale webinar.
All right, so that was the interview, and hopefully you're able to learn some things, mistakes that you can avoid. If you've made these mistakes, how you can fix them and do better instead. If you want more information about selling wholesale on Amazon, highly recommend this link, fulltimefba.com/wholesale workshop. It's a free workshop helping you learn how to get started selling wholesale on Amazon. If the wholesale workshop is closed, then you'll get a link that link will lead you to a wait list where you can be notified when the wholesale workshop is open, because it's only open for a very short, limited amount of time. So again, fulltimefba.com/wholesale workshop. Well, this has been Steven Smotherman from Fulltime FBA and the Fulltime FBA Show podcast. Be sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Great stuff to help you turn part-time hours into a full-time income selling on Amazon. Have a great day. Bye.